Welcome. I'm so proud to be associated with Swarthmore, who has invited the Ohara School of Ikebana to demonstrate some of our school's arrangements. I am our Linda Brinkmann. My nickname is Linda, and I am the student of sub-grandmaster Ranelle Douglas. The arrangement I'm making is the first arrangement you would learn as a student of Ohara School of Ikebana. It is called The Rising Form. Using a container designed by the Ohara School. Inside the container is a kenzan with a little rubber bumper on it. The kenzan is weighted lead with brass needles. Some people call it a needlepoint holder. It's an essential bit of equipment when you study the Ohara School of Ikebana. The container can be used with a flat side, and there are times when you might be doing an arrangement that you would choose the flat side. But today I'm turning it and I'm going to use this arrangement with the curved side of this container showing. The arrangement I'm going to do, the rising form, I have three elements I'm going to use today. Variegated hosta, this will be filler. I'm going to use a beautiful Japanese anemone. And a late season hydrangea that is yellow with touches of burgundy and purple. All of these are from the garden. This is from my garden, and these two items are from Ranelle Douglas's garden. There are two things you gotta know. You gotta know the length of your subject line and the length of your object. Subject, object. This length of the subject is up to two times the width plus the depth of the container. And some of these rules that are used in our school of Ikebana and in other schools of Ikebana have to do with proportionality and the idea of the triangle. For proportionality, I suggest everyone look up the golden mean or the golden rule, which is used by all the grand artists of the world in their compositions. And oddly enough, a very smart person discovered that the golden rule or golden mean, also called phi, P-H-I, is also used extensively in Ikebana on many levels. It would be very fun to do a whole essay about this. So this subject line is going to be a rising form rather than an inclining or slanting form. We were going to measure this against the container. And what you do is you don't count the very tip, because the very tip sort of disappears sometimes. And you measure up to twice the width plus the height. So that's within two times. So if I was at the table, it would be that tall. And I have to decide, do I want it that tall or a little short? So I'm going to measure that again. Twice the width plus the depth. So I'm going to start there, because I'm not going to go any taller than that. And the measurement is from the what you see outside of that container. It's not from the floor or from the table. I'm looking at this, and I might, in my mind's eye, I might look and see what I've got here. And again, I think that's a little tall. I might just bring that down a touch. I'm gonna cut this underwater, although normally I would have a little bowl here. Now, when I insert this, and this is a lesson, so I'm gonna give you the lesson. You can do this at home. When I insert this, I can insert it sort of in the back half of the container, so I have room in the front of the container to work. And this stem can go straight up, or it can tip any 20 degrees from straight up. So there's a circle I can make of this. And I tend to tip my subject lines forward to the viewer. Now that's looking down a little bit. I don't want it to look quite down so much, so I'm going to tip it up again. So that's almost straight up, but this line tips forward a little, which is nice. This little line here is a little disconcerting. I'm taking it off, readjust it. We have our subject line in. So when you go into your garden, pick something that's rising and upright. Something that has a beautiful color or a beautiful line. It can be anything. We've done this with nine bark. We've done it with hydrangea. Just about anything that is upright. And even on one bush, some things will slant and some things will be up. So pick that. The next part of this arrangement is the object, what we call the object in the Ohara School. And I have a very beautiful hydrangea here, and you want that hydrangea to look up. Now, if believe it or not, when you look at your flowers, some will look up and some will look down. That is looking down. Some flowers, it's more obvious than others. But if I go like that, it's looking up. Have your flowers look up when you're a beginner. It's more complicated to use a flower that looks down. And if you see arrangements with flowers looking down and it still looks good, you know the person has some training. So that flower is going to look up. And when I put this flower, the length of that flower, not counting the head again, is one-third the height that you see. So one-third is about there. So I'm going to measure this to about there, and I'm going to cut it a little long because you can make it shorter but not longer. That can be placed anywhere in the front in an area that is 90 degrees. There's my 90 degrees. I'll put this down. That's 90 degrees. And that area in the front where you can put that flower is here. Okay? And you can tip it left or right or straight on. I'm going to, because this is so upright, I'm going to tilt it a left or right. I'm going to put a little point on this end so I can get it in the Kenzan. Watch what I do with my fingers. I take a hold of the branch in two places, place it in the needle holders nice and tight, and then bend it a little to where I want it. Maybe a little more. Okay, and then I have two really beautiful hosta leaves here as filler. And that will go, the filler normally is not bigger than the object. If it is, then it becomes the object, okay? So in this case, I want that. I want to emphasize that and that. So this filler has to be a little shorter. And so that is, you can see we've used only four items there, but three materials, Japanese anemone, hydrangea, and hosta, and that is the rising form in a half moon.